Welcome back to Milwaukee. Well, ghosts and goblins are scary, but not as frightening as the ghoulish habits haunting our finances.
Yes, local financial advisor Brad Allen from Drake & Associates is here to share four hair-raising habits. And this is a good time to talk about this because, of course, next week is Halloween.
Right.
And after that, we're all thinking about the holidays.
Yes.
Holidays are coming up.
Yeah, pretty scary stuff.
Which is a area for spending.
Yeah, that's the first one, so spooky spending, right? So it's looking at a budget and making sure you have a budget and knowing what's coming in versus what's going out. Mm-hmm. You know, it's so important, whether you write it down or you have a spreadsheet at home, just know what's coming in versus what's going out and what are your goals. You can't have goals until you know where to start from, right? So do you want to pay off credit card debt or what does that look like down the road? And I work a lot in retirement, so the closer you get to retirement, the more you really have to pay attention to your spending. Because now you don't have an income coming in anymore, and you have to make sure you know what's going out, you know, on a monthly basis.
And so, a good way to do that, I mean, there are so many apps and websites now that can, like, calculate and divide, like, where you track your spending.
Yeah, and it can do it for you, and you get a spreadsheet at the end of the month, and it says you're spending this much at the coffee shop or whatever it is, and you can pull back a little bit if you need to. Or on our website, wealthwisconsin.com, you can print off a worksheet and you can just fill it out every single month.
Oh, great. Okay.
Is there a certain, I don't know, percentage or whatever your income for like discretionary spending?
You know, it's different for everybody. Okay. It depends, you know, like I said, what's coming in versus what's going out. But you should be saving as much as you can. You know, retirement comes sooner than you expect and you really have to pay attention to that and put money away for it.
Yeah.
So that and, you know, paying down debt. I think credit card debt is a big one too that needs to be talked about. You know, you need to check your credit score. Now, Wisconsin has a pretty good rate.
Our second one.
Yeah. So 701 is the credit score average in Wisconsin, which is pretty
good.
But you have to stay on top of it. And the three credit bureaus allow you to check your score every single year for free.
Okay.
I always recommend doing that and see, is there anything on there that shouldn't be? Should you need to fix anything? And, you know, maybe pay off some debt. There's different ways that you can pay off debt faster than others. So it's just knowing what you have as far as debt goes and then trying to pay that off and come up with a plan.
Because, I mean, your score depends on debt to income ratio. There's so many different factors that affect your score, but if you have a high debt and your income isn't that high, then your score goes down.
And a lot of times there's mistakes on there that shouldn't be there, and if you don't catch it, it's
easy
making yours,
to
yeah, I mean, it can be. If you call them and say this was a mistake, can you look into it, they can get it off, and that's going to raise your credit score. So.
Awesome. All right, what about ghosting retirement?
Retirement is a big one. Yeah. You know, you need to be your own advocate these days for retirement because Social Security, number one, we don't know what it looks like in the future.
True.
They could make some changes to it. Pensions are kind of a thing of the past. Not a lot of people have pensions anymore. Yeah. So being your own advocate, putting money into retirement accounts is really important. I always recommend 10 to 15% per paycheck if you can. Definitely enough to get the match if your company has a match.
Mm-hmm.
But one of the things to talk about here is Roths. A lot of companies have Roth 401k.
A Roth is.
A Roth is money that you put in after taxes. So you pay the taxes first, and then you put it in, and then it grows tax-free, and it comes out tax-free in retirement.
Okay, because, I mean, essentially, when you're older, when you take out the money, then you don't have to pay the taxes on a huge lump sum.
Right, and a lot of people don't realize, but a lot of people are in a higher tax bracket in retirement than they ever thought they'd be in, because in your 70s, if you have a traditional 401k or a tax-deferred account, they start making you take money out in your 70s. So you could have Social Security coming in, maybe a pension, and now they're making you take a lump sum out every single year out of these accounts.
Yeah,
it pushes you into a tax bracket you might not want to be in. So the sooner you start thinking about Roth IRAs and putting money into those types of accounts, it really helps out later
on. And the last one, mysterious markets. Explain that.
Well, the market goes up and down, right?
Yeah.
You never know what's going to happen on a day-to-day basis. So you want to make sure that you have the right risk tolerance for where you are and how close you are to retirement. So the easiest way to do that is the rule of 100. So you take 100 minus your age, and that's the amount you should have in equities. So if you're 30 years old, you should have 70% of your portfolio or your 401k in equities. If you're 70 years old, it should be about 30%. The closer you get to retirement, the more you want to start pulling back on the risk. Because if we go through a big market downturn and you're early in retirement and you lose 20, 30, 40% of your portfolio,
you're not going to get that back.
You don't have time to make it back anymore. So it's really important to pay attention to risk. And the closer you get, you want to, you know, the rule of 100 is good, but you want to really get specific, sit down with a financial advisor when you get closer to retirement.
You have really made this easy to understand.
Yes,
because
good.
Normally when it comes to finances, I'm like,
and demystified it for us. So thank you very, very much. All right, short break. We'll be right back.